baby. It gets exciting, baby.
Y'all think this easy, man? Pay attention and watch the show.
Hey, what's up, y'all?
What's up, though, man?
Sammy Sosa in this bitch, man.
You ain't your smooth bag today.
Yeah, man. You see how I'm giving it up, man. Real player shit going on. Do I look like P in them? Master P in them.
You definitely like Silk and Shaka.
Yeah, I like Silk and them. Cool. You know, I thought I was Silk when I was little, man. All type of No Limit chains and all that shit, bro.
You look flexing. Like Silk right now.
$10, Pensacola Mart. Y'all fuck with me. Y'all remember we had the movie theater, the pawn shop with the fucking speakers, and they had the Pioneers, the motherfucking turntables. That's when they had
the pictures. Remember the pictures?
Yeah, you get big photos. Bob Marley shit. I had a Biggie poster right after he passed.
They used to have like the like that regular gray background that everybody took like in front. You know what I'm saying? They used to put your pictures on a clock.
Y'all still ain't that your picture at Poppy House?
They'll put your picture on a clock.
Picture at Poppy House?
Yeah, I got that picture.
When you and Cannon and Gene?
Yeah, I got it on my phone.
Y'all niggas look cool in that shit too. Y'all had on like Chicago Bulls hats or something.
Legendary Pensacola Mart shit, nigga.
Starter jacket up type shit going on.
Legendary Pensacola Mart shit, man.
If y'all wasn't doing that in the 90s, bro, don't talk to me, bro. Don't try that cool shit with me these days.
For the people that watches this is not from around here, Pensacola Mart was like,
man, that shit was
some
golden.
Shit, man. That shit was amazing, bro.
Mm-hmm.
I can still smell it.
Mm-hmm. Smell like cigarettes and donuts because the donut place.
Or it was grease.
Yeah, they used to dump the donuts and shit. It was like funnel cake almost. Yeah, but you could smoke cigs in there at the time. You could smoke cigarettes indoors, like, you feel me?
They would put them in like a bag. You know how like in your chicken wings, how your chicken wings come in a bag at the Chinese store?
They'll
put your donuts in a bag, dump the powdered sugar in and shake it.
And that shit was never my thing. This nigga used to go crazy on the donuts.
Bro, what, dog? I used to be like, yo, I need a bag of donuts right now.
Yeah, niggas know what's going on. I ain't big on sweets for real.
Yeah. I don't really eat sweets like that neither.
Other than my marijuana withdrawals lately, that been coming along with it, bro. I've been eating hella fucking sweets.
You still going through withdrawals?
My dreams still. A lot of dreams. Hell yeah.
Word.
Yeah, hell yeah.
I had a crazy dream the other night, yo.
I had to change the music I listen to and shit. Like, when I go to sleep.
For real?
Because I don't want to, like, accidentally end up with something crazy in my dream. Bro, I had a dream. I ain't tell you. I had a dream. I looked out the window, and it's like five niggas, like trying to punch on you. One of them was like hitting you and shit, and you was kind of like just chalking it, like, all right, like not falling or nothing and shit. Word. And they was like attempting to jump you, and it was mad weak. And I went to go get your gun. I wanted to go get your strap. And I don't know, I don't know who was stopping me. I wouldn't get it. And they just kept saying, he all right. He's all right. It was like a female. I don't know who. But it was like, he's all right. And then, like, at the end of the dream, I came out blicking and just watched all of them just get scared as hell. And we got one of them and just watched him just bitch and cry. And then we let him go. He bitched and cried and we let him go. We ain't do nothing to nobody, yo.
I hope that don't really happen.
Just had fun just scaring the nigga, and we just enjoyed just whoring them and just playing and just having the gun on them. Like, yeah, bye. And he was just telling all types of shit about the other niggas and everything. Like, we were just crazy. Toying with him. Like, yeah, pause.
Yo, listen. But, yeah. I had a dream.
No bullshit.
I had a dream that I went fishing, bro.
Yeah, that's crazy. Somebody pregnant, bro. You can't have fishing. You can't have fish dreams. You know, as soon as the girls hear this, they're gonna be like, "What the fuck?"
I had a dream that I went fishing. I was with Smoothie.
And Smooth got another baby on the way.
I don't know, yeah, Smoothie.
And it was just Smooth's birthday. And Word. It was just his birthday.
Happy birthday, Smoothie.
He went crazy for his birthday. That's what happened.
I was with Smooth, and I was like, yo, I can catch some fish, bro. I threw the line out, and I just automatically felt the tug. And I remember like feeling like the string like pulling, like feeling it. Like I'm like in the game or something. Like, and I'm like, yo, dog. And all of a sudden, it started pulling aggressive as hell. Like I got it. I'm like, I got this motherfucker. The fucking fish start swimming towards me fast as hell. Like,
that nigga's about to fuck
and
you
up. Then it jumps out the water. And I wake up like, shit. Yeah. Yo, dog, I always wake up. I jumped out of my sleep, bro. No bullshit.
That's funny as shit.
I wonder what does that mean? I stay getting attacked by fish.
A fish attacking you is crazy.
Remember, I just told you I just got attacked by a shark the other day.
Yeah, and I thought that was some pregnancy shit attached to it, but no, The fish be some shit. So Smooth, you know what I mean? Happy birthday, Smooth. You obviously turned up.
Yeah, you T, boy.
Smooth gonna be like, don't put that shit on me, nigga.
Listen, man. I don't know what to say.
That is amazing.
Hopefully none of those dreams come to fruition.
Yeah, we're
none of them. You dig?
Yeah, word.
It is what it is, though. Listen. Come on, man. Somebody got a problem with us.
Somebody got a problem with Rose.
Man, come on, man. Listen, man. Welcome. You dig? It's your boy Caesar Link. Cato. When you getting money like athletes. I'm telling you earlier, man. I ain't listen to Hov in a little minute, man.
For sure.
Hov, you know what I mean? You know, sometimes you gotta throw that Hov on. It's about to get cold out. You know, you see me hooded up.
Words are in the words of Kanye. Good morning.
Listen, man.
Good afternoon. Good evening.
Before I reach my garage. Listen, man. I got my brother. My blood brother. Got a Rudder Rover in the building.
Yes, sir. Rudder Rover.
Where's the love?
Who you think had the most like static growing up, like as far as like niggas having a problem with niggas? Me or you?
Having problems with niggas?
Yeah.
Like, I had a lot of problems with niggas, I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah. I feel like somebody got a problem with Rule.
You know what I'm saying?
But a lot of your shit extended from me too.
From you.
That's why I'm trying to tell my sons, you better not get your brother into no bullshit.
No bullshit. Static was static.
Yeah, it felt it even. Happens, man. It felt even, no matter how it played out.
Everybody went through something in life.
I got nephews to look after.
You know what I'm saying? Listen, man. Not a rapper. Can I live? Like and subscribe.
Yeah, make sure y'all like and subscribe, man. You feel me?
Like and subscribe, man.
What's this?
Comic Club held you down 6 summers. Damn.
Where's the love? What's this, episode 33?
No bullshit.
I don't even know, bro. We can't keep count, bro. We gotta talk to production.
What up? Welcome to the Comic Club.
That's a production.
I am your hostess with the mostest, Caesar Lee, aka Cato, and I got my brother, my blood brother, Rudder Rover in the building. Sipping a lemonade. You know what I'm saying? Nigga,
up,
feeling
y'all?
Like you lounging, nigga. You got lemonade, you got your feet kicked up.
You see how I'm giving it? I got back. On my shades, man.
You feeling good? How you feeling, man?
It
you
ain't
feeling
even
good?
Sunny.
It's no sun.
It's dark out. You feel
it's dark
me?
Out.
It's dark outside.
How you feeling, man? You feeling good?
Yo, hell yeah, man. I'm feeling hella good. Halloween just ended and all
man,
of that.
Man, clap it up for Halloween. You feel me? Clap it up for Halloween, baby.
Man, you feel me? The kids went crazy. You feel me? Got to turn up one time.
That's love.
I got the, you feel me? I'm in a good space, you feel me? If y'all, some of y'all who know me personally, you feel me? I fell off, but you can't tell, you feel me? A nigga fell off a little bit, but now, you know
man,
mean,
it happens, baby.
You feel me? Yeah,
it happens to the best of us.
Ain't nothing, you feel me? Little
you know
fall offs and shit like that.
Did you do anything for Halloween?
Fuck no.
Oh, you was chilling?
Hell yeah, and the kids' mamas did all that shit.
Man, I was at a trunk or treat. I did one trunk or treat this year, dog, because Kai mom, Meek be trying to take Kai to 30 trunk or treats, every single one
crazy.
In every town. Yeah. Look, man, I don't be wanting to do all that. We went to one trunk or treat, and that was at his school, and we did a trunk. You feel what I'm saying? So Kai,
being the trunk.
Clap it up for my lady, my baby mama.
Yeah, being the trunk for the treats is cool.
She doing what she's supposed to do. She put the trunk together. She did an amazing job. I come up there, ghetto as hell.
Yeah, word.
Grab my son up.
You know, she the DIY queen,
word,
for
man. Sure.
She the DIY queen.
That's her
man.
Shit. So I grab up, you know what I'm saying? Kai, take them around. They got the trucks. They got the cars lined up, like, in the parking lot, big-ass parking lot. So we going around, taking Kai everywhere. He just looking for his homie. You feel what I'm saying?
Right.
It was crazy. He looking for his homie the whole time. Because my son don't eat candy. You feel what I'm saying? Kai don't eat candy. So
word.
He don't be on it like that. So he don't really care. If it's lollipops, he cool with that. You feel me? Like, he'll rock out with the lollipops.
That's how Bam is. He just like to do the shit.
Yeah, like, but he'll just do it. But he don't be, I eat all the candy for real. Right. You feel what I'm saying? I'm sick of candy at this point. You feel what I'm saying?
So, shit. Except for them nerds.
Except for these. Except I'll never get over these.
Yeah.
But so we going around the joint, you feel what I'm saying? He find his friend, you feel what I'm saying? He go kick it with his boy. Now it's dark outside, so the playground. All the kids on the playground, they running wild, bro. It's nighttime. Big ass playground. Like, they are cutting up. Ain't no light on the playground. Like,
right, it's one of them.
Imagine as a kid, you in a costume in the dark with all your friends on the playground.
And mind you, this playground you used to be in.
Yeah, you used to at school. You feel what I'm saying? You only see it. So now you out there in the dark. Now they're running wild, bro. Like, they're having a ball out here on a playground.
Yeah, they
like,
love that shit.
They tweaking. Like, and they all in costumes, so they like tripping. You feel what I'm saying? Like,
they feel fucking evil.
Candy in them. They like going crazy. You feel what I'm saying? So we letting them cook. You feel me? Now, Kai, you feel me? Him and his old boy, he's running around. They running around for a little minute, man. These three little girls walk up on Kai, talking about, "Hi, Makai," like this. And they all hug him. All three of them. And I'm just like, yo, what is going on? And you know, Kai, he ain't going to talk much. You feel what I'm saying? He just hug everybody. You feel what I'm saying? Just gave everybody a hug and just kept it pushing. You feel what I'm saying? But I'm looking like they just like, good. Like, they little girls. You feel what I'm saying?
But you know what's so funny? Because like, us being adults is automatically like halfway fast shit to us. Look at these little girls being fresh.
Leave this little boy on. And not to mention, it was clear.
All right.
It's clear girls.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it was clear girls. Clear girls.
So
that's how I be at the mixed up schools. Words,
mixed
boy.
Up schools, man.
Yeah, our kids at it the was mixed a clear up girl. Schools, man.
So, you know, his mom, you know, sarcastic, we joking, but she's like, yeah, it was funny as hell. Like, but that was that. But as far as that though, let's just clap it up for Halloween, man.
If fuck around and be like that, you feel me? I'll be like, just don't go. I'll be like, just don't go too white.
Yeah, don't go crazy. You feel what I'm saying? At least let her wear like a you know, the white girl.
Yeah, make
like
her look mixed or something. Yeah. Give me Kim K vibes.
Kim
something.
K action or some shit like that. You feel what I'm saying?
Let her have some lips or something, bro.
Yo, that's crazy. Yo, like, did you see any moms going, you know, the girls, you know, shout out to the ladies, they was going crazy for Halloween.
Yo, look, no, last Saturday, nigga, stupid. Everybody was outside, nigga, man. Everybody was outside, and they said, y'all took Halloween away from the kids, ladies, that's what they said.
They sure did.
They turned it up.
Man.
And they give them another reason to just,
that shit,
you know
like
I mean,
carnival.
To get cute and all that shit, yeah, and get a little sexy, you feel me? I don't knock it, though, because it's like, all right, go have your good time and all of that shit, but it's just dangerous because Halloween is kind of like, the idea of it is just a little like...
creepy a little bit. Now, so it's just like, when you get older and think about it, like...
Yeah, so it's like...
There's some say... Like, when I see adults walking around with the crazy creepy, I'm like,
right, it's a little bit
where
too
am
much.
I at?
And bro, it's like, yo, once I see... You know, I can't be around too many people with masks on and things of that nature that. Thinking that I'm just having a good time, you feel me? So it just get pretty creepy, you feel me? Like, Halloween parties, it's like, it give a little evil energy a little bit.
Word.
You feel me? On the low, word. So... And, you know, I'm paranoid, so, you know,
How you feel about the moms dressing sexy at the trunk of treats?
At the trunk of treats
with the sexy
at the trunk of treats is wild. But in general, do y'all fucking thing. I feel like women should dress sexy whenever the fuck they want.
Yeah, it's your body, your choice.
Yeah, your choice, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I feel like they should dress sexy whenever the fuck they want. I'm never going to be on that because it's like, shit, we got to go to the beach.
But, you know, it's always that one. You feel what I'm saying?
Mean?
That one parent that's going to come, that one mom that's
going
to come with the shit.
I mean, shit. You know what's so crazy, though? It's like, I mean, shit, somebody entertained.
Word.
Because I ain't going to lie, like, but we was different kids than, like, our children. You
word.
Feel me? Let me keep it tall with y'all.
I'd have noticed that.
But as a kid, we would, what?
Yo.
Yo. I remember a nigga.
She got the thong going.
I remember, yo, I'ma send this shit to you too, nigga. This nigga brother lied on Miss Reedy, man, my third grade teacher. This nigga lied and said he did something with her and all types
word.
Of shit, bro. Hell yeah.
Somebody
bro,
did like, that. Don't have us going viral.
Yeah,
then they talking about,
bro.
Yo, somebody did. Who
yeah.
was it?
Miss Reedy ain't do nothing. We know that shit was a lie, but at the same time, it's still crazy because it's like, yo, little niggas is little niggas. Like, even like Miss Marshall back in the day, like I used to love Miss Marshall. She was a first grade teacher, but she wasn't my first grade teacher. And I had Miss Armstrong though. And I used to be like, yo, I love Miss Marshall. And I remember Meech went and told her, and she said, oh, tell Rashawn I like him too.
Yeah, I remember.
She said, tell him I like him too. I told everybody, but I say, yo, she liked me. I'm like, Miss Marshall said she liked me, nigga. Like, yo.
He's probably scared to go near her for like the rest of the fucking
year. I wanted to switch to her class, nigga. I was never one of them. Once you give me the green light,
yeah,
that's when it's up. I said, oh no, she said that she liked me too, bro. And mind you, I took it way left field.
Took it personal.
It's like, yo, don't tell no little kids you like him too, y'all. It's for all y'all little, cause I got some chicks who teachers. I'm going to send this to my teacher friends, too.
I never had a crush on a teacher before. I only had a crush on one teacher, bro.
Yeah, Miss Cologne. Everybody know Miss Cologne.
Yo, listen. Miss Cologne, right? Miss Cologne was something special, bro. Like, it was to the point where...
Wasn't she a Spanish teacher?
Spanish teacher, bro. We got into arguments and everything. Me and Miss Cologne were like...
And she was Spanish, right?
Yeah, she was Spanish. She barely spoke English,
That's
bro.
That's kind of cheating.
She was wild.
Like to be a Spanish teacher and you just full and you barely speak English for real. That's your job. That's like unfair.
Miss Cologne was something else, bro. I'm talking about, I don't even know how they let this lady come into the school. Like, you know, the older ladies, they had to be hating on her. You feel me? Because, bro, she would come in with the tight skirts, the blouse, the white blouse. She was she was something else.
And you got to think, bro. It was like male teachers there. So
yeah,
you gotta
nigga,
know like
all,
this
nigga,
shit.
They would pull up to the classroom. It would be the guys coming, the guy teachers. Walk up to the classroom asking the shit, violating, you feel what I'm saying? Like on some real other
look,
shit.
Bro, that's no different than us as adults, like working at any job and it's like a female there that's like bad or whatever.
Yeah, for
but
sure. Like now as an adult, yeah, I see how much time they on.
Bro,
yeah.
like Miss Yezzy got pregnant. You feel me? Yeah, like, she got married. She became Mrs. Iannucci, respectfully.
100.
She got married. But I never forget at the school dance, fifth grade school dance, coming out to the hallway before there was a thing, seeing Mr. Iannucci talking to her. They both there off work hours because it's a school dance.
They
you
probably
did?
Snuck the wine in there.
Yo, come on. You know they was drinking in that motherfucker, man. Coffee mugs and shit.
Yo, even when I think about all the teachers that was at the school dances and all that, like,
bro, we was drinking in the school dance.
Yeah, word. So you know they was in there talking
about
it.
We got kicked out for that shit, man.
Word.
We got kicked out for drinking at the school dance, bro.
I ain't went too many school dances. Like, I
man,
think me and my niggas,
we
was on some
man.
Dumb
we snuck in that bitch.
I think, no, I went to, matter of fact, I went to like two school dances one time, and that's when I got this crazy lap dance from my folks, and it was like, she was wild, and we didn't know how to, I knew how to dance.
Yeah, I got dumped at one school dance because I danced with another girl, and then that's when my girl at the time dumped me and shit. That was the one we snuck into, and I was drunk. We was off E and J and shit.
Yo, say tweaking.
Niggas was off Irk and Jerk, bro. Little ass boys, bro.
Like I ain't go to the homecoming dance. I went homecoming court, and I ain't go to the homecoming dance. I ain't know I was supposed to go, and I fucking. What happened?
Oh, that
I
was when you won Duchess or something?
Yeah,
Dutch.
Nah. I don't know.
And Duke and Duchess? Duke. It's Duke and Duchess. There you go.
Yeah.
All right.
And I won
I don't
that
know
shit.
That much, y'all. I ain't making that far.
And I ain't motherfucking didn't even go. You feel me? Because I remember I had a girlfriend at the time. And she was already mad because I won it with Shorty. You feel what I'm saying? And she,
that's a crazy thing to
I ain't
hate
gonna say
on.
She's mad.
Nah, but you automatically be jealous. But
yeah,
and you my
we was
folks
kids,
too. I remember.
You know what
I remember you hated on that though.
Yeah,
I fought the same day. I got into a fight that day. Cato walking. It's like a whole movie. You know when like something good happened and it's like a presentation and it's something dramatic going on and like
it
on
was
Belly,
just like one of the
like
movies.
On Belly when he was making
I'm doing
the speech.
Something. I was doing something amazing. This nigga over there doing something stupid.
Yo, what you call it? This nigga try to run down on me and I'm younger than him.
No, I got
smaller
the same situation.
Than that nigga.
I had the same situation at my fucking graduation and shit. No bullshit.
I just said who had more issues, me or you earlier. That's crazy. That's a crazy look. I had a lot of bullshit with me. But right. That nigga was older than me and he ran down on me. And you know what I mean? And I beat him the fuck up too, you feel me? Munch was there. No, Munch was like up the block. He just saw my do-rag like lifted because the nigga teed on me and was punching me and shit. Nigga lifted my do-rag. Nigga punched my do-rag back all the way this way, man. Pussy. Nigga knocked my do-rag back.
No, that shit was crazy. Where was we even talking about, bro?
I still beat you the fuck up. We were talking about trunk or treats and shit.
Yeah, we were talking about trunk or treats.
School events.
Then we got the
and
teachers.
And at night, and how fucking Miss Yezzy got pregnant by Mr. Iannucci in elementary school.
Yo, that's crazy.
And we was like, yo, y'all was fucking.
We went off on a tangent.
We said, yo, y'all was fucking. Yeah, that's how it's supposed to be. First 20 minutes, man. We might need a man.
I heard you say, now let me ask you this question. You feel me? I heard you, you know what I'm saying? Because you said you got dumped at a school dance, right?
Hell yeah, man.
You ever did some wild shit over a breakup? Like some wild shit, like some shit that's out of pocket. Like, yo, I violated. Like, why am I doing this? Like some shit that
it was.
Making...
Yeah, it wasn't necessarily.
I did some wild shit during.
It wasn't
breakup,
necessarily
bro.
Over the breakup, but yeah. it was during the breakup. So you know, it was like a buildup of shit. It wasn't just like we broke up, so I did this. You feel me? But it was just a buildup of just a lot of shit.
I'm talking I'm talking about like the petty shit too, like. Like, not even just like, I did, like...
Man, dumb shit and crazy to me, I punched the wall. You remember, I broke my hand and my wrist.
Yeah, that was dumb.
Some of y'all probably remember my shit being broke and shit. Y'all don't know why I was casted up.
Word.
I broke my hand and my wrist. I punched a wall, and it was a firewall, and a complex wall. So that shit was like concrete and shit, and I cracked my shit all up. I thought I was going to put a hole in the mug.
I hopped over a security gate one time.
Oh yeah, that's crazy.
Yeah,
that's
bro.
Crazy. Because now other people, like now you like now nah, you have
I had,
other people
I had an accomplice with me and everything.
Okay. Oh, so you were sliding.
I was sliding,
yeah,
bro.
You were sliding. Everything. You know, I do shit dolo. Like I pulled up dolo. Like I wish you would be with another nigga. I pulled up dolo before.
Nah, but this accomplice and this accomplice was a girl.
Oh, okay, word.
You
what the
saying?
Fuck was she supposed to do besides snitch if y'all got caught?
She took me over there.
Did she know what the fuck she was getting
herself
into? Yeah,
she knew. She tried to stop me.
Oh, she's trying to get punched on.
Nah, she...
Yeah, look.
I know she
any chick pull up on me after a breakup and you got a nigga with you, y'all both, and then now it's a
nigga. I wasn't
nigga.
Even
who
thinking
the,
at that
who
time.
Who the fuck is you, nigga?
I wasn't even thinking about that at that time. You feel me? Like, at that time, I was like, oh, hell no. Hell no.
Yo.
Oh, hell yo. No. What's that movie? Hold on, what's that movie?
Nah,
with,
you
with
jumped
the, nigga?
The gate. Fuck a movie. You did the Matt Barnes,
did, yeah,
nigga.
Nigga.
Shout out
yeah,
to all
I
the Matt smoke,
Barnes,
man.
Bro.
Matt Barnes, he
Matt
pulled
Barnes.
To you, my nigga. You feel
I
me?
I definitely pulled the Matt Barnes, boy. I was
respectfully
over there.
Had that nigga running and bruh, shit.
Bro, I'm talking about jump the security, like the gate for the, couldn't even get into the apartments.
Oh
the gate,
man,
everything, bro. I
so what security saw you approach
nah,
security? Nah,
it wasn't no security. It wasn't no security. It's like it was one of those
gated
communities. Gated
community. Okay, got you.
You know what I'm saying?
You.
I had to jump the gate.
I had
to jump over that motherfucker,
up.
Yo. And Shorty just like, yo, don't do this, yo. And I'm just like, fuck that. Fuck that. I'm going in.
Why is she trying to get beat the fuck
yeah,
up?
Yeah, nah, she wasn't going to get beat the fuck up. She wasn't even on no tight time. She just like, yo, bro.
Nah,
I don't
but sometimes
think...
you catch them strays like when they get heated and it's relationship
related. Nah, but this the thing. This the thing though. I don't think it was that. Cause
it'd be like, girl,
what
the fuck
the,
are you supposed to
I
be?
Was the. It'd be different if it was like I was the dumper, but being a dumpy is like
okay,
you just
word,
like
word.
You, they don't be thinking about that. They don't give a fuck. They like. They
hey,
get,
worst
both
part
y'all,
is
both y'all get the fuck out of here.
Worst part is I was the dumper.
You was the dumper.
And still was tweaking.
Like, see, now, that's, now you're out of pocket. That's out of pocket,
it
bro.
Wasn't even a dumper. It was like an agreement.
That's so, what is that?
But
there's
I,
a name
I,
for that.
I kind of initiated
there's
it,
there's a
though.
Name for that.
I kind of initiated it, though.
It was, but listen, that, there's a name for that.
Sure. Fucking crazy.
Nah, yeah, crazy. But there's another name for that.
You need help. You need therapy.
No, it's
dumbass.
Called, not gaslighting. It's one of them hot words right
what,
now.
What, am I a narcissist?
Narcissist. You're a narcissist.
I'm a narcissist?
Yes, bro.
Thank you. I kind of like to be.
You're
I kind of like
bro.
When they consider me a narcissist because it's like, you feel me? Me. It's all about me. Play with
word.
Me. And it's all about me.
Narcissist.
No, but for real, I think that's real love if you do some shit like that. Because it's like, for real, like, yo, for
word.
You. Because if you can just, like, get over somebody and just not give a fuck, then it's like. It ain't as official as
you ever did something ever petty did. Like during the argument, like violate, like do something stupid, like some wild shit, like
yo, I
like
try.
take all the backs of what they say, take the backs of earrings and some shit.
Yo, I try nah, fucking earrings.
Yeah, did some
I try,
wild shit.
I try to throw the engagement ring out the window.
What? That's not. Yeah, that's kind
of on crazy. The highway, nigga.
What?
295 type shit.
Nah, that's crazy.
Get the fuck off my shit.
Yo, nah, that's crazy, yo. That's crazy.
Yo.
Yo, I did something. Yo. I did
we
something.
Almost crashed behind that shit, man. It's all love, shit. Though.
I don't even want to say some of the shit that I
engagement
did.
Engagement ring on 295. Yeah, a little nutty, ring, though.
Like, I've done petty things. Like, petty as shit.
You ever had some petty shit happen to you?
Petty shit happen to me?
Because I got one before you just get into yours.
Go ahead.
All my left shoes was missing.
What?
All my left shoes were missing.
All your left shoes.
All of my left shoes.
That's crazy.
I got
bro.
To the crib like, yo,
Where are my left shoes?
Yo, I swear on my life, all of my left shoes was gone, bro.
Where?
I had a pair of pennies. I had these white and red Nike Air, these white and red Forces and shit. The little, you know, with the red trim and shit. And yo,
all my left shoes,
bro. Some Tims, all lefties.
Damn. I don't think nobody ever did nothing really petty to me during a breakup. Like, word. I think it just be more like arguing and shit like that.
Right,
like,
right. Shit just be sad.
But I ain't never really had a lot of girlfriends. You feel what I'm saying? So I ain't never have to deal with too many breakups.
All my left shoes was missing. I earned that after the wedding ring shit, though.
Yeah, that's crazy.
After the engagement ring shit, yeah, I earned that.
My boy. You out of pocket for
that. Yeah, all my lefties, and she wasn't going to tell me where they was at, and it's like, I had one pair of shoes, the ones I had on my feet already. Damn. When I got there.
Yeah, nah, I can't, like, I ain't never really go through nothing like that. Like, somebody do some wild, petty shit. Like, I've done some petty shit. Like, I've had the nigga call my phone and I just motherfucking telling what's really the fuck going on. I did shit like that.
Oh, I did that before. I'll never do that again.
I wouldn't do that again. I was young when I did that.
I was young.
You know
also.
What I'm saying? Like, so that was crazy when I did that. Like, I remember.
Let's see. Go ahead. You remember what?
I just remember when Shorty, like, when Bull called, I don't even think he even called on some violating shit. He called, like, on some, like, yo, look, my nigga. I just want to know what's up.
Oh, he
you
called
feel
you
me?
Cool.
Like,
oh,
cool
so
as fuck.
So you called yourself keeping it real with the nigga.
Like a nut. That was corny. Like, I just gave up the tape.
I
like,
mean, yo, but like,
nah,
on the flip side of
shorty, bro. Like,
on
man,
the flip, on the flip side of the coin, that's real nigga activity. Cause I would want to, especially if the bitch cheating on me, bro.
Yo, he said, bro, listen.
Please.
I get bitches. I get money. I remember he saying all that. He said, yo, bro, I'm a fly nigga. You feel me? He said, bro, just like on some shit.
Damn, you
let me know, bro.
You were supposed to tell him, bro.
I was supposed to tell him.
You were supposed to tell him, bro.
Yo,
if
yeah,
he's saying
that's crazy.
All of that and he like, yo,
yo, he kept
nigga,
it so
should
real.
I exit or should I take
bro,
this L, bro?
He didn't even violate my nigga. He didn't call wildin'. He said, bro, listen, I don't even really give a fuck for real. He said, I just want to know from like not I'm rewording it, but this is basically what he was saying.
Right, right, right.
I want to know for my sake. You know what I'm saying? Like, for the sake of me.
Now, for future references, you know fellas, this is what I want y'all to understand. Word. If you got to call anybody and ask, y'all see how my hands just did? I dapped y'all just now. If Word. Y'all got to call anybody and ask, that should be your answer
that's enough
right
there,
bro.
That's enough.
That should be your answer right there, bro. If you got to call somebody to figure it out and to get in to be like, hey, is it this or is it that? Fuck it, bro.
Yeah.
Hang it up.
That shit
nigga,
was wild, man.
Because a nigga might not keep it tall with you because, you know what I mean, that's his pussy too. So he might just.
But I ain't even really deal with shorty like that. So I just was like, man, what?
Right. And that's the thing. A nigga might have some, and that comes with respect also. A nigga might have respect for shorty to where it's like, I ain't even about to fuck her day up, her life, whatever up. I ain't about to fuck her shit up. So I ain't going.
I don't even know if that was like around that time. We ain't have like crazy text messages.
Yeah, it wasn't.
And shit
I
like
remember.
That.
I remember that.
You know what I'm
remember
saying?
That.
It wasn't even nothing stupid. So you know, niggas do a lot of shit when it come to these women, man. These
yeah,
women
but now these days, my niggas, up. If y'all gotta call and ask my nigga, just hang it up, bro. Because after that, you ain't going. Regardless, you probably not going to trust her.
Word, word, 100%.
And if you like, yo, yeah, I'm calling. You know what I mean, I'm just calling to see. I really don't give a fuck. No, you calling, so you give a fuck, bro.
Yeah, you
so
give
either,
a fuck.
So you can either see what you saw and take it how you want. Or
real,
be prepared to possibly be lied.
In my head, I always felt like I did some sucker shit.
For sure. No, on your end, for sure. On your end, you should feel like a sucker.
Damn.
On your end. But on his end, though, Right. You was a real, if a nigga really wanted to know, to be like, yo, bro, like,
I did some was it shit, just bro. Some,
cause a bitch might slip up and fake entertain a nigga once, yeah. You feel me? And it's like, shit, that might be the case, like, but.
I did some sucker shit, man. Y'all gotta get
but
a
nah,
one,
you
one,
helped bro
man.
Out. Nah, now that it's said, now that it's done and over with and it's years old, bro, you did some real nigga shit, bro. You kept that nigga from witnessing word. His girl getting spanked. And all this shit,
yeah, word.
By fucking Willie Bobo and them all up the block. You feel me? Like, so it's just like, you know yeah. How that shit go. Like,
and that was fucked up, man. Shout out to Shorty, man. I apologize. She probably don't even like that nigga no more. She probably.
Nah, they done with now. He left her.
No, for sure. Hope. Doubt it.
You think he probably kept cracking it?
Yeah, you already know.
He probably like, man, that shit hit.
I ain't mad at him.
That shit
hit. You know what I'm saying? Go crazy. You feel what I'm saying?
That shit hit.
I mean, at least, you know what I mean? She ain't catch you getting your meat ate like Meg.
Yeah,
you
know word. What I'm
saying? Shout out to Meg. Shout out to Party, I mean. Getting a decent wet ass meat. Dog. Why do women like embarrassing themselves?
Getting that dick sucked where I sleep.
Now,
I say, whoa,
and they,
no,
and
not
they,
me.
They were like, I'm, of course, after she dropped that verse and that shit hit the internet, I see all the girls in the comments talking about, these niggas will embarrass you. Da, 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 da. Like, yo, listen.
Nah, you know what's crazy?
No,
that you
bro,
say that, though?
Nobody even knew about
this
shit.
I ain't gonna lie to you, bro. I ain't gonna lie. A lot of the top comments is, well, you was moving messy, messing with all these niggas in the industry.
Yeah.
And then even while y'all together, the baby coming out saying that he was fucking you and all this other shit. And then a week after y'all broke up, you had a new boyfriend. So
oh, yeah.
And so it was just so. And then
he probably already knew you was moving wild.
And
like,
right. And you know how everybody say, oh, well, before word. Them, it don't matter or whatever, or after them. But you got to think some niggas look at that. Like yeah. A thing, for real. For no yeah, matter how yeah. You, no matter how you do it, bro, a nigga gonna look at it. Your respect level might change for somebody depending on what they was doing.
Yeah,
you feel
what
me?
They like, was into. You feel me?
So it's like
that's, that's the same thing as when a bitch see a nigga, when a bitch see a nigga ex, and they be like, ew, like that's yeah, that's who you was
right,
dealing with.
Like, right, and it's like, yo, you
nigga,
was letting everybody
you,
crack.
How the fuck you get me?
Yeah, and I could see if it was like years before, like it was on some phase type shit.
Yeah,
this shit was like. A year before, on, this
you know,
was
you know
six months
though?
Before they got together. You was out
you know
here getting,
crazy
getting cracked on.
Them party niggas really be on fire with that type shit. You know what I'm saying? Because didn't party niggas do say that in that song, Don't Hold Your Breath? When he was like, when he's like, VIP,
shit.
I got my dick sucked. Got out of the nigga to kiss you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He's like, what? Oh, he said, not a hotel got a smell now.
Yeah, like yo, it'll make a nigga feel crazy if it's like yo, I kept you for real, and it's like damn, like you
and
did
the
all
fact
this shit,
that he
and I'm
posted
finding
a future,
out.
He posted a future meme.
Yeah, he said there's a lot of evil things in this world.
Come on, man, you already
it's
know what time. You know what that means.
Yo, shout out the future for coming through and liking the post, man. Future came through. Future
you know
pulled up on the Comic Club podcast.
Shout
now,
out
look,
my nigga Pluto.
Mind you,
man.
We never give a fuck about niggas liking shit.
No
we gotta make
I just
this clear.
Was on here popping shit about you niggas. Posting these fucking celebrities,
yeah,
liking
and y'all
shit,
views
and
shit
and views
or whatever,
and, shit,
and
all
liking
that,
shit.
You feel me?
Word. But Future a little different, bro. We
yeah,
gotta
man.
Keep it real,
come
bro.
On,
we
man.
Gotta
I
keep
get
it
so
real.
So now
bro.
I almost gotta take back what I said because that might be somebody to y'all, whoever likes your shit.
Not word, you word, word. It might be somebody so, that yeah, a word. Person might really, really look up to or yeah. Whatever the case may be, but. It's kind of different when like, cause like that's like when people like might share a story and shit.
Yeah.
But then you go to their story and they done shared 1,000 other stories and shit like
yeah,
that.
That
you
sucks.
Feel me? Like, so it's just like, damn, like I'm just one of 1,000 motherfucking stories. You already know pillow up, nigga. Yeah, pillow yeah. Up, nigga. But yeah,
I got bad back.
But yeah, but it's like, yo, 1,000 stories and shit. So it's like, all right, that's cool. But if it's like, yo, this nigga never online. He never liking shit. He never yeah. Commenting. You feel me? And the whole post is about Pluto for president. And shout out yeah. To KO because if without him here, we wouldn't have gotten to
we
such
definitely
a,
wouldn't have even gotten to the subject.
A,
of,
yeah,
talking
a
about
heavy
people.
Discussion for my boy. You
word,
feel me?
Word.
And that's one of our goats. We already know.
Yeah,
future
you already
one of them
know.
Goats,
future
man,
my
so.
Nigga. You feel what I'm saying? You know, I be you know a lot of future gets played in the whip.
Yeah, it was good. It was good to see my guy come through, man. The shit fuck right after, as soon as we got done filming,
word.
The episode with Chill, our very last episode. Soon as we got done, this nigga was like, "Yo, Future just liked the post."
Word.
He said, "What?" I said, "Hold on, what?" He said, "Yo, Future just liked the post, nigga." So
yeah,
I had
man,
to go check for
cat.
Myself. Like, hold up, man. Let me see Pluto! Something real quick. And
hype
that's the
shit.
Thing. This the thing for the people that's on the internet. I want y'all to stop. When it comes to like counting like likes and shit like that, or like looking at what it is, or even if it's your story viewers and shit like that. Like
that shit don't matter, man.
I always said, bro, say if you had one story viewer, right, every day, or one like every day, but that like and that viewer was Beyonce every day.
Word.
That shit means way more than your shit. Fucking 400, 500 likes, than your viewers, than your amount of views, whatever. You feel
me? Word.
So it's you got to remember who watching, you feel me? It's not always about the amount of people that's watching. Yeah. You can have a bunch of nobodies watching, but you can literally have somebody see your shit, believe in you, and change your life. And like my nigga Brody say, man, you never know who's watching. He tell me that shit all the time. Rudder, you never know who watching, bro. Duh. When Dej Loaf posted me, he said, bro, you never know who watching, Rudder. You on your way. Okay. When Rick Ross came through the pages, liking and commenting and shit, yo, you never know who watching, Rudder. So it's just always the same cycle, man. So don't get caught up in this shit, man. It's about who you know, man.
No
who
bet. You know. No bet, man. But yeah, that shit is crazy. So I don't know. It's crazy if this nigga Party really got his dick sucked in the crib that he shared with Shorty. He is out of pocket for that. I'm not going to lie. Like, I'm a firm, don't do that.
Yeah,
you feel what I'm saying? Like, that's the one thing you don't do. Like, don't try to, you know what I'm saying? Like, I didn't always think like that. You feel what I'm saying? You know,
but that's
in my younger days. Like, you know what I'm saying? But now I think that way.
It's kind of like
don't do that, bro. Don't bring no chick in your crib.
That's where that respect level come in again. You feel me? Where it's like, all right, if I'm lacking respect for you, whether it might be on some shit like he might have gained this lack of respect. He may not have always felt like that, but once it's like, damn, like yo, I'm seeing all this shit you doing. He finding out more about this Tory situation than what it's supposed to be. He probably know more of the truth than we all know.
Word.
You feel me? Because it's a lot to it. But you see more shit happen, and it's like, damn, you fucking on your friends' niggas this often? This more than one? This like the second or third time we done heard about you fucking on your friends' niggas that they supposed to be talking to?
And you know they gonna really play it like that, too. They gonna take it to that level, like, oh, yeah, he was doing this she was doing that. You know everybody be talking in the industry, so he probably done told him a million things.
He knows a lot more than we know.
Word.
And for real, some of it is probably a good amount of true, because she even denied fucking with Tory at one point. And then it was like, then it came out like, oh, nah, that's a lie. You feel me? Like, oh, no, that was a lie. You feel me? Then the baby was like, yeah, shit, I cracked too. You feel me? Like,
Blueface said Blueface
said he got head from her.
Is it money bag, yo, crack.
Is all these niggas
really like, is it these niggas talking too much though? Like, I ain't never seen this many niggas talking about
it's both
what they did with one girl.
For real. But the thing is, it kind of like some of it kind of come with the territory a little bit, even though you don't have to.
Yeah.
Territory is crazy.
Word.
Terror and Tory. It's crazy, but yeah, punchlines on y'all fucking niggas. But it kind of come with the territory for real. It sucks, and it's kind of is chatty, but at the same time, it's like shit. Like a nigga like the baby who just basically was canceled at one point, and it's like shit. This shit gonna go viral.
You gotta have some type of that's a lot of disrespect.
I was gonna say niggas be losing respect. That be the respect level. Niggas hear more shit, more and more shit, and be like, yeah, I fucked that bitch. And it ain't nothing to be like, yeah, I fucked that bitch. Cause now the respect level ain't there from no end. You feel me? And it's just like, damn, I can't even be like, yo, like, if a nigga talking about you like that, yo, he don't respect you.
And it'd be like, what type of this, what was it might be added up disrespect in the house. You know, she popping shit. You know, she probably bringing more cash than he do.
Word.
A lot of disrespect in the house, probably a lot of shit. It's like, yo,
you was smashing the baby, you was smashing Tory. I'm fucking 6'3". Both of them niggas is 5'5". What the fuck? This shit, the baby 5'5", Tory 4'3".
Yeah.
And it's like you letting these fucking midgets crash you out and shit.
Yeah, that's
like,
crazy.
Like, yo, niggas is going crazy. You mad over Kylie at the house? All the live videos resurfacing. Yeah. You feel me? It's shit that's like getting nasty. Where it's just like, yo, man, fuck her, bro. Like, he probably like, fuck her.
Did you see the clip from the video that she about to drop?
Yeah, I saw a Cobra. It was
like Cobra, the Cobra shit.
Yeah.
I like the fact that she was kind of like being vulnerable, opening up on the record.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
of course,
not just giving you. Not, I mean, it sound like, you know, she some shit she going to twerk to, but.
But no, she kept it. It's not, she's keeping it real.
Yeah, she had some type of what they call substance to
yeah,
the music.
Word, word, word. It sounded like she was like, definitely keeping it real.
Like she on some
I ain't
shit,
gonna
like
lie. As soon as she said, "Damn, I miss my parents," and I was just like, "Shit."
Yeah, she.
That was kind of all I needed to hear. That's kind of what I wanted, like, to hear, like, from Drake a little bit, like some real life shit. Talk about some family problems or something.
Yeah.
I was just like, I don't want to hear about bitches getting on your nerves all day. Like, I don't want to hear that all day. Like, talk about your homies getting locked up when they used to, or trapping or something. Yeah. I'm just like, do it for the dog.
This,
but
I don't know what he did on this joint.
Yeah, but anyway, but yeah, but that's the type of shit that'll pull people in, you feel me? Yeah. Where it's like, no matter what, even though I'm rich, it's still a struggle with this shit. You feel
but
me? Like,
people is gonna definitely tune in because just off the strength of just her giving samples of what she's going to probably be talking about on the album, and I think that was a good way to get people.
And it's legit. I don't think and it don't seem forced.
Yeah, she ain't talking about nothing. She ain't saying nothing stupid. You
know
what
like
saying?
She could have fucking. She could have been like, "I'm dissing the baby." You feel me? Like, yeah, no, she's not dissing
the baby.
She probably doing the album, but we gotta go tune in for that. But she talked about like just real, kind of like the real life shit that she was dealing with. So you know. I respect it, for real, for real.
Yeah, nah, I respect it. You feel what I'm saying? But who knows, man? These people be in the way, man. These celebs, man. Y'all wilding with the vids and all that. Mm-hmm. She had cobra shedding skin. I ain't like all that. I was like, oh, that's whack.
For real?
Nah, I ain't like
that. I ain't see that much of it.
She butt ass.
I just saw her naked and like her titties covered or something.
Butt ass naked, which was, I'm sure she wasn't butt ass naked in the video shooting it. But the way they edited it and all the
right.
shit, she's butt ass naked in the video and she's shedding her skin and I don't know, she's coming out as a serpent.
She's shedding her skin. Okay, so she's starting over.
Yeah, man. Or she's coming alive, Illuminati.
Okay, where is she done with? She been illuminated. She tried to do some fake shit.
Yeah, you Illuminati.
Yeah, where is she? Tried to do some fake shit, man.
Yeah, man. I hope she don't do it.
Yeah, Party can't do with a future meme. No, shout out to Future for coming through.
Man. Party, you bold for that. You're a real one. Clap it up for Party.
That's when they say he guilty automatically. It's as soon as you post that.
Automatically guilty.
Yeah.
ain't no one even like questioning that shit. You did that shit.
Yeah, that's when they say.
He said, yo.
As soon as he posts a Future meme, he gets ill.
Yeah, dog. You already know, dog. Future is really the face of this toxic shit, bro.
Yeah, man. Thank you, Future.
I like Future, man. I like that. I like that Future.
Thank you, Super Future.
That, man. I'm about to play some Future on the way to the crib tonight.
Yeah, you already know. Glacier. I ain't listening to that shit in a minute, bro.
Yeah, that's my shit. You feel what I'm saying?
Like, and I put Blown on the Weed.
What, nigga? The Future. Niggas need to put a little more respect on Future name, man.
Yo, on YouTube, y'all look up Six Glacier.
Word.
Six Glacier. It's an album. It's an unreleased album. It's a leaked album, yo.
Word.
I call it Dirty Sprite 3.
Word. Yo,
real
listen.
Talk.
Let's get it in this real quick, bro. You remember Joe Johnson?
I didn't.
Okay.
I didn't remember.
Yo.
But now, then I saw his face.
Yo.
And I said, I know that nigga. I remember him for 100%.
Now, let's get people the scenario.
Man.
Joe Johnson is a former NBA player. I remember he used to play for the, I feel like he played for the Sixers for a little bit. Joe Johnson also played for, I don't remember the teams he played for, but I just remember the nigga a lot because I was a heavy NBA boy. You feel what I'm saying? So
I can't believe you lost all them basketball cards, bro.
Yeah, dog.
Bag
right
shit.
Now. Who knows? Some fucking.
He had the Michael
somebody,
Jordan
some kid
cut
probably
above
got them.
Card, bro. Michael Jordan cut above card.
Yeah, or a crackhead probably sold them, Jones. Who knows? You know how that go.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? Them shit's probably gone. But motherfucking, yeah, man. So Joe Johnson's in the NBA, right? Former NBA player. Finds out that his wife has an OnlyFans. No, don't clap it up for that. Gunshot.
Joe Johnson should have turned into Joe Jackson.
Yeah,
go
Joe
Jackson.
Wow, bitch. Wow. Like, yeah, what the fuck?
Finding out your wife got an OnlyFans.
It's crazy.
And she looked like she like 50, nigga.
Bro.
50 years old, bro. That's
man,
fucking
no.
Wow.
Listen.
That's wild.
Listen, no. It's
nigga.
Wild. It's wild. It's wild, bro. Like, I don't know if this shit was planned, but they said she's a porn star already. She's already a porn star. She was a porn star. You feel me?
Okay. So that was her. And it was her going live, or was she just recording?
No,
when they
I don't
was talking about it.
No, she started recording.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Which I don't know if that was just to promote her shit. You feel what I'm saying? Get her shit jumping.
So. Man, that could be.
Or what? But, bro, listen. If I find out that my wife got an OnlyFans, man.
That's, and she said, you knew what it was when you met me.
Yo, that's crazy. No, that's disrespectful. That's crazy. Disrespect. She was disrespecting this man. Like,
yeah, word.
She was violating. Like, yo, nah, man. Like,
that's like
nah,
if a nigga was just had a bunch of hoes when we met.
Word.
But y'all married and shit now, word. Nigga. You're not supposed to have the hoes no more. So, like, you can't say you know what it was when you met me. When you met me, you're supposed to change now.
I'm now, like, the way I see it is they might be falling on some fucked up times.
They trying to promote, bro.
Or they might be fucked up on some paper. You feel me? He been out the league for a little bit. You shouldn't have put that in the
air, cause now I believe it's all promo, bro.
Word. You feel me? But like, now she started saying, like, I gotta do what I gotta do because, you know, we in a situation. So now I look at it like this, right? I'm like, damn. Imagine as the man, right? You know you try and do whatever you can to provide.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying? Like, you know, make sure shit is not going the way you want it to go.
You sound like Tupac. Do what you gotta do to survive.
Word.
And still I see no changes. Can a brother get a little peace?
He ain't getting no peace, my nigga.
I see no changes.
Shorty said, yo, look. And she starts to OnlyFans on you and she getting paper. You feel me? Like, but she playing with a box and doing all that. Like, yo, I would have to. With she got to go. She got to go. She got. You got to cut her off, bro. Listen, man. She got to go. Listen. I tell you this. I couldn't deal with that, bro. I couldn't deal with that.
I wanted to know, do they have children?
See? Now, that's another thing, right?
That was my big question. Do they have children, man?
That's my thing, bro. I'm not going to lie. Listen, man. I'm doing this segment like this. Let me tell you something, right? Fellas, Will Smith.
Oh.
Joe Johnson.
Oh.
Party.
Fellas got it. Oh.
Who else, man?
Hey, fellas.
Who else need a hand? Listen, man.
Shit, somebody else need a hand.
Fuck that.
Fat boy SS.
Fat boy,
fat. Fat boy SS.
Listen, man. Big dogs for the dogs. This is the energy that Drake needed. You heard? For the dogs.
And to top it off, this for all the dogs. It's a new season.
Listen, man. PSA for all the fellas. Tighten up, man.
Yeah, tighten the fuck up.
We gotta do better today.
Mm-hmm.
All this shit going on, man.
Ain't no way y'all women should be acting out like
that. Yeah, man, it's wintertime, man. They supposed to be coming back.
And they supposed to be behaving.
Behaving.
Everybody should be on their best fucking word. Behavior.
Come on, fellas, let's tighten up, man. And please believe, she ain't the only one.
Yeah, for real.
Feel me? Might feel like that she the only one for the first month. Brother said he been having withdrawals from stopping smoking weed. Imagine getting the pussy. Come on, man.
It's all the same. Damn, brother, that was deep.
We gotta do better, fellas. If she wanna go, let her go. If she wanna go, let her go.
It ain't nothing. It ain't nothing.
Had to do that, man. It's for the dogs, man.
It ain't nothing.
Like, we doing a lot of wild shit out here, man. We on the internet tweaking. You feel me? I'm saying, and I get it, man. We be in love with these women, man. That's what happens, man. Men, we act like we don't be on some shit, but nigga, let a breakup happen. Niggas get the crushed.
Yeah.
Niggas get depressed. Niggas be sick.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Fucking stomach. They
end up
punching fucking walls and shit.
Walls and jumping fucking gay community fences and shit. Doing the most. You feel me? fellas, listen. Before, like, keep this shit, clip this shit, whatever you got to do. Listen. Whenever y'all got that feeling and you feel like, yo, damn, my shorty out there doing it, you got that feeling to do something dumb, nigga, go do something.
Get you some real nigga healing. And word. When I get that feeling, get some real nigga healing.
Wait,
nigga.
Pause.
Not from a real nigga, but what a real nigga needs to be healed. You feel me? Yeah, you feel me?
Go call the homies up.
Yeah, call up the guys, get you some wings, go to a little strippy. You ain't even gotta go get your man ate or nothing.
You ain't gotta do none of that.
You ain't gotta get your meat ate, you feel me? Word. Get you some wings, go to the strippy, man, and forget about it.
Yeah, forget it. Go to the strippy, you feel what I'm saying? Talk to her about it. You know
let
what I'm saying?
Bitch, let a bitch tell you that you handsome. You might not. A bitch might not have told you that in a minute, man. A bitch might not have told you that in a minute.
Listen, man, fellas, you going through a breakup, man. Go to Sin City.
Yeah, word.
Go to Blue Flame, my personal favorite. Go to Magic. Go to Starlets.
Hey, yo.
You know what I'm saying?
And for all the married men, yo.
Yeah.
Take her by the hands, yo. And say, babe, let's pray together.
Let's pray.
It's going to mess her head up. I promise
word.
It's going to have her.
I don't know. You might got a demon on you. She might tell you, fuck your prayers, nigga.
No, and then, no, look. Yeah, that's what. So then that, you'll get your answer right there. You'll get your answer right there.
There you go.
The guilt either going to crush her.
Yeah.
The guilt either going to crush her or you're going to realize that she's a pure demon, fellas, bro.
Now, don't try this shit if you got caught in some shit. Don't try to pray your shit.
When you close your eyes, she gonna dump the shit out.
Don't try to pray your shit.
She gonna dump you, nigga.
Don't try to pray your shit.
And then she like, I'll pray for you.
I'ma pray for you, nigga.
I pray for you and your fucking black eye.
I wonder how many niggas did that, though.
I had to take the glasses
nigga
off.
Get
of
caught
that.
Up. Niggas get caught
pray
up in
you
some
and
shit.
Your black eye,
nigga get caught up in some shit talking about let's pray.
Let's pray together.
That's a Jackson. What's name? Derek Jackson shit.
Yo, it's bright as shit in here. You was living like this this whole time, man.
I'm loving this shit. You feel me?
Bright lights, big city, man.
You know what I mean?
Shit.
You know how shit go.
Damn, it's bright.
But that's funny as hell, man. Like, yo, listen. Fellas, if you find out your girl is doing anything,
yeah, I ain't get duff, y'all. That ain't why
like,
I have my shades on.
I've been in a situation close to Joe Johnson's situation years ago. Close to Joe Johnson's situation.
What,
I've
like
been
Only
in a situation
fans,
like
shit?
That. No, it wasn't OnlyFans.
Ah, shit.
It wasn't. OnlyFans wasn't even out, bro. Around that time.
Right.
You feel me? It wasn't OnlyFans. It was some wild shit. I'll get into the story another time. You feel me? I'll never put nobody out there. This shit is hypothetical. You feel what I'm saying? All this shit is wild. I'll never say nobody names. I'll never do none of that. But I've been in a situation close to Joe Johnson's situation before. Listen, man, I know what he was going through, brother. And listen, what you do is leave. Leave, brother. Leave. Don't do nothing crazy. Just leave, my brother. You feel what I'm saying?
Please,
get
brother,
out
leave.
Leave, brother.
Yeah, we just like, fuck with them right
you
quick.
You feel what I'm saying?
We eat them all, nigga. Him and them Jones.
No, I ain't even go crazy.
He was going crazy.
I was going stupid.
Have the pack gone, man.
Yo, dog. I think I ran out of topics, bro. I got a million topics on here. We can talk about the motherfucking Eagles versus the Cowboys. We can get into motherfucking James Harden trade to L.A. That's crazy.
Fuck the Eagles and the Cowboys. We're going to dust them niggas.
Nah, we're going to go stupid on the Cowboys. Pause. You feel what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
You feel what I'm saying? Everybody know. Shout out to my Philadelphia Eagles, man. We got a big game this weekend coming up. By the next pod, we'll be talking about if we took the L, if we took the W. More than likely, God willing, we're going to take that W.
Man. I don't wish failure on nobody.
Word.
But I'm waiting to see James Harden do fucking terrible.
Yo, word. Word. Now listen.
Usually we get sports out the way first, y'all, but we about to start putting it on the end every episode.
I don't think I want to see James Harden do terrible, man.
I do.
I think he just did like what he said was stupid. Like about he doesn't fit into a system, he is the system, which is gonna be hard when you go into a team full of fucking stars. You're gonna need a system because everybody's gonna want touches and everybody's gonna want the ball in their hands. So
wanting touches and the ball in your hands is crazy.
Pause, bro. I ain't even mean to violate like that. But everybody gonna need. You feel what I'm saying? So
look,
it's gonna be hard for them to play together.
I feel you, but fuck James Harden, bro.
Damn, bro. Damn.
The nigga
bro.
Lame, bro.
Yo, man, stop coming at my man.
And this
James
the thing,
Harden,
bro. This is what I've learned though.
I might want to hit the strip club with James Harden one day.
Like,
that shit might be fun as hell.
Yeah, I'm gonna tell you, fuck you, bro. But that's out of.
Damn, bro.
The hurt, nigga.
Yo, damn. Why you hurt?
That's out of the hurt, nigga.
But you gotta understand why you hurt. He needed to leave, bro.
No, he needed to show up, and then them niggas at the big niggas at the office was like the topper. Pause. But the execs in the offices is like, nigga, fuck no, we not giving them no max for what, nigga? You got to max play to the max first, nigga.
How you think he gonna do in LA, man?
Not as good as everybody's assuming.
I don't think they gonna be shit.
Cause look, this is what I realized. even you see, you kind of see it happening with Dame Lillard. What, he had like 6 points one game, he had like something light. Yeah. But we gotta realize we can't move off of names and stats no more in the NBA, bro. Yeah. We gotta literally see how players play together.
Word,
and we can't. Sure. We should have learned that. No, that from shit the don't matter Lakers.
No more. Ain't yeah, no more. Ain't, that super team shit is out the door.
I'm a Lakers nigga.
That big three shit is done.
For like, sure.
That ain't no,
even
ain't no
you
big
even
three.
Saw with the Suns last
yeah,
night.
Yeah, that shit.
The
ain't
Suns
about
last night, San Antonio was had them niggas scared.
Word.
Motherfucking Devin Booker and KD had to snap. They had to turn up. Like, fucked up one of my bets too, because I thought that one of them would go on to 25
points. I took a break. We was about to get go tonight. I took a break. I'm like, man,
yeah, they fucked
tonight,
up one of my
man.
Bets too. But they you got to see, but it's like, it's kind of
fucking weak.
It's kind of like the team chemistry. All right, okay. Then we kind of need that. We need that that underground player, that one that's kind of the underdog. You feel me? To come shit on games. Like, that's what we need. We need a niggas need a bench that got good players on it. That we don't need the super teams. The super teams always end up fucking up, bro. Word. It ain't the same no more. We got to see how they play together. And I feel like this is about to get weird. James Harden needs to play off the dribble and shit. He don't need to play off the pick and roll.
Word.
He ain't the same. Westbrook been showing up. Shout out to Russell Westbrook.
I just want to see how that whole dynamic going to work out. I think they play tonight, so hopefully.
I wanted to go bad, though. I wanted to go bad because it's like, my nigga, you ain't show up for us, and you kind of, and that diva shit killing me, man.
I don't like the way he did it. You feel me? But I get why he did it, but I don't like the way he went about it. He could have just been, a dog, a professional, and just said, fuck it. You feel me?
Like, then everybody's like, oh. He's with two former MVPs, MVP candidates.
That don't mean
PG3 and Kawhi. I said he was just with the current MVP. He was just with the current MVP.
They're gonna need him to do the same thing they needed him to do in Philly, facilitate. You know what I'm saying? And he doesn't want to be the facilitator. I mean, maybe PG probably be the facilitator, and James will play off the ball. But who knows, man.
Don't fuck around and be shitting. Don't get me wrong.
I don't think they gonna do shit, bro. I ain't gonna lie. Like, I don't think nothing gonna happen over there.
They fuck around and be shitting, but it's something that we literally gotta see.
He just home. You feel what I'm saying? He just home.
Then we still got Kawhi and PG and PG and them niggas be playing like 40 games a season out of 80 or some shit.
We gonna see how many games they all play together. But they put a rule in so niggas can stop that resting your players, resting the superstars.
Mm-hmm.
Can't be doing that.
Wasn't they legit injured, though? They be having legit injuries. Them two be having legit injuries.
Kawhi don't be injured, man. Kawhi be
capping.
Cap.
He be getting old to relax.
I call cap. Yeah, man. Shout out to them Sixers, man. Hopefully we turn up, man. I'm watching Milwaukee. I'm watching Philly.
Shout out to my Lakers. Bron still playing
high
like
level.
His motherfucking 25.
High level,
you feel me?
High level.
And that's when people debate with me when I say the greatest of all time, not
Word.
That time.
Word.
All time. Year. If somebody plays great for 40 years and somebody else plays great for 10,
yeah,
you're greater of all time. You feel me? Like, so you feel me? So that's what I mean when I say that.
Yeah,
that's my GOAT.
I would say LeBron is the greatest of I ain't gonna never say it's hard to I hate that debate.
I gotta tie it up.
It's a lot of people that are great, bro, that were great at what they did. You feel what I'm saying? So it's like,
but who was great
ain't
of
no
all
top,
time?
Of, ain't no GOATs of all time. There's no such thing.
Not who's
exist.
The GOAT of 10 minutes.
Man, listen. The goal of, I don't
if you
no
go to a
thing.
Job and they say your productivity and they say you did great this hour, but out of 8 hours of the day, nigga, you only did great 1 hour out of 8 hours a day, and a nigga did great 7 hours out the day, nigga, he's the greatest of all time.
You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna say LeBron is going to be the greatest of all time, but I'm only gonna say he's going to be the greatest of all time because he's not done yet. You know what I'm saying? It's a lot that he's still doing, so. When it's time to start talking about, I won't consider him a GOAT until he retires. You feel what I'm saying? Like,
I feel you.
Now I'm able to speak about you amongst the other players that we call GOATs, and they're all retired. You feel what I'm saying? So when
yo,
it,
that
when,
nigga might have three in the tank, bro.
Word. Nah, he might got more than that, bro.
Yeah, he might, he think he got five.
Yeah, bro.
Brian
yeah.
fucking around have five
he,
in the gonna, tank.
No, he'll be there when his son is there.
Word. He fucking around have five in the tank.
He'll be there for
gonna
a year,
be there with,
a year
Bryce.
With his son, bro.
He fucking around be there when Bryce get there. Y'all
bro.
Talking about Bronny.
We'll see.
He fucking
we'll
around be there when Bryce
bro,
get there.
He still got the same bounce he had when he was 17, bro. 18, 19, bro.
That shit is crazy.
He's still him.
He's still jumping and...
Jumping out the
sending the shots to the blocking shots, sending them to the fucking moon, bro.
Yeah, bro, that's still him, bro.
One block that he had last night was it last night or night before? Maybe, I don't know.
I ain't been watching the games,
insane.
Bro.
I don't miss them. I don't miss the Lakers.
You said you don't be missing them?
Mm-mm. You know, my boy, bro, you know I don't miss my bro. That's my bro, like,
yeah,
for real. So,
that's
texting before, after the game. He's like, I'm cool, bro. I'm ready. I'm ready for another 80. And that's how we rocking.
That's your folks.
You know how we give it up.
Hey, man, listen.
On phone
man.
Now.
Listen, dog. FanDuel, y'all getting all my money. I'm sick of you niggas.
Y'all know I'm a DraftKings sportsbook nigga. Yo, niggas got to start using them promo codes, man.
Yeah,
if y'all gamble online, bro, them commercials, please take advantage of those commercials. When y'all watching basketball games, they give y'all promo codes and things of that nature, bro. Or football games, they give y'all promo codes and things of that nature. Use them promo codes, bro.
Word.
Them shits is all they throwing them around like hotcakes right now.
Nah,
like,
no cap.
Go to this shit and type in a promo code, bro. And you can get bonus rewards and all types of silly shit. So
word.
It's shit that we gotta look into. And the shit is start adding up. You might get a little bonus reward for you know it. You like, oh shit, I got a little
sitchy.
Yeah, but got a little $10 to play with on this motherfucker. Okay.
Word.
Might turn that into, I mean, play rub a leg. Rub shorty leg with that shit. You feel me? Might wish get you some good luck like a genie, motherfucker.
Yeah, you already know, dog. Listen, man. We came up on the hour, man.
When I said rub a leg, I thought about on a Christmas story where they had the lamp. That's a fucking
I don't
leg.
Like how they're rushing Christmas this year, dog.
I love it.
Slow down,
you know I'm
bro.
A Christmas nigga, bro.
Slow down, bro.
You know I am a Christmas
nigga. No, 100%.
Nigga.
I feel you.
So the day before Halloween, I said, oh, I can't wait till this shit over.
Nah.
I said, I can't wait till this shit over.
Yeah,
bro.
Like Christmas, I mean, like, I don't mind. Like, I love Christmas, but don't rush this shit, bro. Like,
oh, Martha.
Slow down.
Oh, Christmas. Yo, I found a new Christmas comedy and shit, too.
Word.
And I don't even remember what it's called, but it was type funny so far. It was on Prime. And then they got, check out The Night Before, y'all, with, what's my man named? Seth Rogen.
Oh, yeah, that's my
Seth
shit.
Seth Rogen and Black Dude. That should be an every year banger for y'all. The Night Before is definitely a killer. Harold and Kumar Christmas is a killer. Very Merry Christmas, definitely a killer. Y'all should look into, of course, the classic Friday. Friday After Next to Christmas Edition, you feel me? With Ricky Smiley, Terry Crews, Cat
that's
Williams.
That's a good one. Word.
All that good shit, you feel me? That's a nonstop killer. I like the Adult Jones. I meant to watch Violent Night, that crazy shit.
Nah, yeah, that one too. What's my favorite? What's my other Christmas movie? Chevy Chase.
Oh, Christmas Vacation.
Christmas Vacation,
hell
baby.
Yeah. With the grandma, great grandma praying and shit.
Is your house on fire,
yeah.
Clark?
Is your house on fire, Clark?
Right,
yo, get ready to pull them fucking classics out, y'all. I still watch the cartoon Grinch.
I watched Cartoon Grinch. I watched the
Jim Carrey.
I watched the old ass Rudolph the Reindeer.
Yeah, the little clay,
one.
The clay shit, right?
The clay one. I still be watching those. Like, all
yeah,
that. I be having hot chocolate with
that's
some fucking
money right there.
With the marshmallows. We going crazy. This is the first year that my son actually was just like, yo, Christmas. I'm ready for Christmas.
Word.
Like,
he
on it. Like, Christmas.
It's time
Let's
to get
it.
Real, bro. The aisles when you going to the stores now is cracking.
Yeah, it's cracking.
I said, oh, man. Niggas know.
It's time to start
Christmas,
shopping
bro.
Now, though. You feel niggas me? Like, know. Everybody, every week.
Hey, look, y'all. And this is
grab
the thing,
your little
y'all.
Shit
this is
every
the killer.
Week.
Yeah, please don't wait, y'all. And this is the thing. Get
Word.
Ready to get... If you fucked up, prepare yourself to get one big gift.
Word, 100%.
But at the same time, y'all tear up five and below.
Word, for the people that's fucked up.
Family Dollar.
Mm-hmm.
And even if you're not fucked up, it's good fillers. You feel me?
Word.
If y'all got kids, it's good fillers. So y'all go there. If y'all go to five and below and you going five and below with $100, nigga.
You're going to go stupid. So basically get 500.
Crazy.
If you can't get 500 by Christmas, it's wild.
Yeah, word.
Get 500. But get spend 300 on something crazy. You know, all the kids want a game system.
Yeah, you might
they
need
wanna,
a,
they
might need the PS5.
You might need an
something.
iPhone. They might got iPhones to sell or something.
iPhone.
Get you, I mean, go grab one of them
or a new
crazy.
Game for their current
game
system.
For
they,
yeah,
couple
for sure,
games.
Shit like that. Couple games, extra 100 on fillers.
Where a little bike, so maybe a power wheel joint that's 300 or the little, there's 400 for the little, for the Lambos and all that.
You feel me? Like, cause you gotta understand, most damn near all kids got that one big ass gift that they gonna ask for.
Right.
Like a lot of kids ask for a lot of big shit, but they don't even really care as long as you already know they main shit they gonna ask
right.
for.
Right. And that's all like they want. And if it's fillers that they can open up in between, and you done fucked them up at, and mind you, when I tell you five and below is one of them shits, even though the shit gonna break in a week, everything gonna break in. It's kids though, they don't give a fuck. They just know that they opening fucking 30 other gifts and it's like, shit, this, that, this shit don't stop.
Just get them their main thing. That's the, that's the key.
Get the big gift and go crazy.
Focus on that
below,
and then go
man.
Crazy after that. You feel me? Like, but if you can swing it, go ahead, go to Target, man. You feel me? Let your kids pick out what they want.
Shit,
you know
if you
saying?
Got it
Let's
like
do.
That, do y'all thing. Yeah, I mean, turn up. Play. But other than that, download them apps. Download them Family Dollar apps to y'all because they're going to give y'all discounts on many things that you purchase, man.
This year is shit.
Nigga,
last year, Christmas, I went stupid on niggas. You feel what I'm saying? So this year, Christmas, we got a podcast we trying to run. We trying to take this shit to the next level. I can't be splurging all this bread.
I do the same shit every year.
Word.
A couple little big shit, a bunch of little, just little. Go to every fucking Dollar General, Family Dollar. Get 20 things, bro. I'm telling you, get a bunch of shit, bro. And it's just gonna be like,
I don't know about Dollar General, but
they got toys. They got regular toys, just like a bunch of places. Hell yeah.
I ain't never shopped for toys.
That shit just like Five and Below toys. They got toys every
Five and Below
aisle,
got
bro.
Fire shit though.
They got everything, but see, they should be breaking just as fast too. But they got shit. It might be like $15 or something.
You talking about for like what age?
Everything. You know, my kids is all ages.
Oh
bro,
yeah.
So I gotta get everything. So it's like, nigga, a fucking army tank here, remote control army tank here, this shit, this remote control car, this shit. All you gotta do is press a button. It's a walking dinosaur. That shit $5. Little niggas is just snapping. You know, so it's just like shit. Like yo, so it's just like shit everywhere. You feel me? Like that's all they need is shit everywhere, and they need shit to work for just that week. You feel me? And they big shit gonna last because that shit costs a couple dollars more. Likely it's gonna 100%. Last longer. You feel me?
For sure.
And you just turn up like that. That's for my folks who really trying to budget for Christmas. Yeah. Start now. Don't be rushing. Don't be in these stores losing your fucking mind.
Yeah, don't lose
up.
Your mind, man.
I never forget almost getting in, like, trying to get this Ninja Turtle bike for Romeo that this nigga rode probably like fucking six times. Like, yo. I'm losing my mind trying to get this bike. I'm on the phone with mommy like, yo, I'm over Christmas, yo. Like, it was so much shit.
Rudder get annoyed fast, too. It don't take much for this nigga to get annoyed, bro. Man, what the fuck, man? Like, yo,
quick. Everybody driving stupid. I remember motherfuckers got on my nerves before my homie baby shower, and I almost skipped that shit.
Yeah, see, this nigga really be on some other shit.
I was like, I'm not going, bro. I had the baby shit in the backseat and everything.
Wild
I was like, I'm not
hell,
going to this
bro.
Nigga. He was locked up, mind you. I said, I'm not fucking going, bro.
Just be wild. But yeah, man. Yo, listen, we on an hour and some change, man. My back is starting to fucking hurt. So I don't want to even.
You should trip it up on pillows. This episode, y'all see, I'm leaning back. I really don't be leaning back that much. Nigga, leaning back.
Make sure y'all like and subscribe to our podcast too, man.
Subscribe on YouTube.
Make sure y'all hit the button and do what y'all got to do. Make sure y'all like and subscribe, man. And if y'all need us to do, small businesses, big businesses. If you need any drops from Cato and Rudder, if you're an artist, anything, you feel me? You need a drop. You feel what I'm saying? You need us. Play your music, whatever. It's a couple people I still owe to play their music, but I'm going to play their shit. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah, but other than that, y'all got a link with it, and we going to talk some business.
For sure. And, make sure y'all check out www.pouritupmobile.com. Book Pour It Up Mobile for your latest events, for your events coming up, weddings, birthdays, bar mitzvahs, barbecues.
Learn how to spell the word pour. It's not P-O-R-E or P-O-O-R.
Yes. Pour It Up Mobile.
P-O-U-R, It Up Mobile. The way
or
the word
check them out on Instagram,
spelled.
Pour It Up Mobile, for sure. You feel what I'm saying?
You really
make sure y'all do that.
Motherfuckers how to spell some
for
shit.
For sure.
They will Google the word pour.
So you already know, man. I got my hoodie on. You feel what I'm saying? So, you know, a nigga ain't got no haircut, man. I got to go see the number one barbershop in motherfucking Jersey. Next level experience, man. You already know. Got to check out my nigga Gee. Real quick, man, get my shit chopped up. My shit looking crazy, man. Shout out to my brother Guy,
man.
Yeah, dig, you know what's going on. And shout out to our people over at Voltaire. the newest, hottest recreational marijuana dispensary in New Jersey. You already know what's going on. Grand opening coming soon. We're going to have them on the show soon.
Hey, you know what's so crazy about that? I think that's when I'm going to go back on my weed. Y'all know I quit.
For sure.
That's when I'm going to relapse.
Word. I don't mind you getting on your relapse shit.
That's when I'm going to relapse that day.
You know what I mean? It is what it is. So, you know, make sure y'all shout out to all our people. Shout out to all our partners, man. I know we got a few more partners than that we got to promote, and we will get to everybody. You feel me? But, you know, we rocking.
Yes, sir. We need some liquor.
Yeah, we need, you know, let me start fucking with Deuce again. Man. You want to fuck with Deuce again?
Yeah.
You want to start pursuing that again?
Yeah, because I'm.
Man, listen.
I'm sipping right now, and I'm like,
I think let's get back. Let's get back to Douce. It's warm.
I gotta pee.
You feel me? He's gonna make holiday drinks for Douce. You feel what I'm saying?
Word.
Yo, word. Douce. I think we back with the Douce shit. Fuck it. Hov, what up?
Yeah, one of the partners that Rugs, we had back in the day, I don't think she worked with Douce no more.
Yeah.
That's what Rel Carter told her. Shout out to Rel Carter, Jay-Z nephew.
Yeah.
He said, I don't think she with us no more. We was like, yeah, that's what our folks, man. Yeah, she's those fucking our folks with back us, in the day. He said, I think she might have left.
Yeah, word. You feel me?
I think she might have left us.
Word, no bullshit. You feel me?
Why the fuck you leave us? Because when you left them, you left us.
Word.
Shout out to Rugs, too.
You know what I'm saying? So you know what's going on. Hey, listen, man. Let's Gary get the fuck up out of here, Rudder.
Yeah, man, I got on my men in Red black chicks. Shades, man. You feel me?
You know what I'm saying? You know what the fuck going on in here?
Yeah.
No, listen, we ain't doing all that. Fuck all that.
Yeah.
Listen, man.
I saw this get posted for Halloween, bro.
Listen, man.
Too many bitches be hitting my line, but
thank y'all for coming out, man.
No, I cannot be your lover, girl. I am a villain.
Whoa.
Unless you think you're good at Harley Quinn.
Listen, man.
Like the Joker with his Lambo spinning.
Listen, man. Thank y'all for coming out, man.
Bro, niggas. Thank y'all.
Yo, y'all hear that Cato Rudder playing, man? What y'all think, man?
Broke niggas. I snuck y'all in because Christmas coming up.
And gave y'all advice on Christmas.
Yeah, because Christmas coming up. I snuck y'all in because Christmas coming up.
Word. You know what I'm saying? Rich niggas. Yo, get ready for holidays, man. They gonna be hitting you the fuck up.
Yeah, man. Don't throw no engagement rings out the window on the highway.
Yeah, word, man. Get your girl that nice ring. Get her that Van Cleef. You already know she want that Van Cleef, man. That shit about four bands of bracelet.
Get her a little
Get a nice little bracelet, man. Little Tiffany.
You know what I'm saying?
Sipping Douce, having parties on the ceiling. I get in foreigns, I don't get into my feelings. But she get on the gram, hit them angles and start filming. Goddamn, show a nigga how you working if you working with much. I do these shit just like the work, I just bundle them up.
And pray for your loved ones.
It's gonna be a cold winter, start bundling up.
Like a spider web.
Day 100 and up.
Pray for your loved ones like a spider web all the way around. From the aunties, to the uncles,
to everybody,
to the mom-moms, to the pop-pops, to the children, to the nieces, to the nephews.
And we is out of here. One yourself.